Hey guys, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a comparison video of the BMW B48 and B58 engines. Right off the bat, the B48 and B58 are very similar engines. Both of them power most modern BMWs from 2017 through the present day. There are a couple variations in exactly when the B48 and B58 took over from the preceding engines, the N55 and the BMW N20, but for the most part, the B58 and B48 really started taking over in 2017. The B58 did come around in 2016, but in the US, the B48 was mostly 2017. But nonetheless, point is, both of these engines power a vast majority of BMWs from 2017 up. The B48 is the smaller 2-liter inline 4 turbocharged variant with 180 to 255 horsepower and 200 to 295 pound-feet of torque. The majority of B48 engines fall right around that 250 horsepower and 250 pound-feet of torque mark, just kind of right around there, depends exactly on which model, but most are right around that. The B58 is a larger engine of the two with this 3-liter inline 6 configuration. This engine pumps out anywhere from 322 to 382 horsepower and 332 to 384 pound-feet of torque. So solid power and torque advantage for the larger B58 engine. Both of these engines do share a lot in common. They both have the same 82mm times 94.6mm bore and stroke. They both share the same rods, pistons, the exact same displacement per liter, so that allows BMW to actually use those same rods and pistons across the engines. They both use a single twin-scroll turbocharger, direct injection, dual Vanos, and Valvetronic. They also both share a closed-deck engine block. They share the same connecting rods, which are forged, as well as a forged crankshaft on both engines. Really a lot in common. The biggest difference between these engines is the fact that the B48 is a smaller 2-liter inline 4 engine, whereas the B58 is the larger 3-liter inline 6 variant of the BMW B-series engine family. Jumping right into the actual comparison and talking about some differentiating factors between these two engines. Number one, we have reliability. Most importantly, the B48 and B58 are both very reliable engines. Big improvements over the preceding engines like the BMW N54 and N55, which were both also 3-liter inline 6 engines, and same thing with the B48, solid improvement over the older 2-liter inline 4 N20 engine. They're both very reliable engines. It's hard to pick a clear-cut winner and say that, oh, the B48's more reliable or the B58's more reliable. Really, a lot of it just comes down to how well it's maintained and a little bit of luck of the draw. Some B48's out there are going to be more reliable than some B58's, and on the other hand, some B58's are going to be more reliable than some B48's. So, not a perfect answer as to which is more reliable. Now, one thing going off of that, of course, the smaller B48 with its inline 4 design, compared to the larger B58 and its 6-cylinder design, the B48 is going to be a little bit cheaper to maintain. When you look at replacing things like spark plugs and ignition coils, of course, the B48 only has 4 of each, whereas the B58 has 6. So not a huge difference, but certainly does make the B48 a little bit cheaper to maintain simply because of a smaller displacement. But ultimately, we're calling this a tie between the two engines as to which is more reliable. Moving on to the next topic in the B48 versus B58 discussion, we have tuning modifications and aftermarket potential in general. So the B48 on its stock twin-scroll single turbocharger is capable of making upwards of about 300 wheel horsepower with the stock turbo. On the other hand, the B58 with its stock turbo can push pretty close to the 500 wheel horsepower ballpark, if not even a bit beyond that mark. So that's where the B58 really starts to shine above and beyond the smaller B48. Of course, it does have the 50% larger displacement as well as 50% more cylinders. So naturally, it's going to be the more capable engine, but things start pulling away in favor of the B58 when we do talk about these tuning and mods, with 300 wheel horsepower being roughly where the B48 caps out and the B58 is capable of upwards and slightly slightly beyond 500 wheel horsepower. We're getting into more of a 60% plus advantage for the larger B58 engine. Similar case applies when you look at the upper limits of the engine before you have to touch rods, pistons, bearings, head studs, anything like that. The B48 on the stock motor is good for anywhere from about 350 to 400 wheel horsepower, whereas a larger B58 can handle upwards of 700 wheel horsepower on a totally stock, unopened engine. Slight advantage to the B58 there. The B58 really comes out as being the more capable engine overall. That's not to say the B48 is bad by any means. Of course, 300 wheel horsepower on a stock turbocharger from a small 2-liter inline 4 is nothing to be ashamed of. That's solid performance, but it's not anything crazy or groundbreaking by modern standards, whereas on the other hand, the B58 being able to achieve 500 plus wheel horsepower on the stock turbocharger and just what the engine's capable of in general certainly makes the B58 a little bit more impressive than the smaller B48 engine. Ultimately, point is, the win here goes to the B58, and if you're looking for the most capable, most powerful engine between the two, then the B58 is certainly the clear-cut choice there. Now, moving on to a category where the B48 catches a win is fuel economy. So if you look at a 330i with the B48, that gets about 30 miles per gallon combined city and highway, whereas the B58 and the 340i is right around 25 miles per gallon. Of course, the exact numbers change depending on options, all-wheel drive or just rear-wheel drive, and some other factors like additional options you throw on the car that may change weight or aerodynamics. But ultimately, the B48 and its smaller displacement has about a 5 miles per gallon advantage over the larger B58 engine. So nothing significant, but if you're just looking for a fun, sporty engine that's mostly just to get from A to B and you also want something economic, the B58 is still a great engine, but the B48 is likely the better choice in that situation. All right, so moving on to price, one of our final topics here before summarizing the B48 and B58 comparison. Of course, the smaller B48 is typically in lower end models, and as such is going to be the cheaper option of the two. So looking at using the 330i as an example with the B48, on the cheaper end of the market, you'll find those for about 20 to 25,000. And this is looking at moderate mileage examples, nothing with 120,000 plus miles on it, but looking at cars that are about 50 to 60,000 miles, you'll be shelling out about 20 to 25,000 for the lower end of a B48 330i. So that'll be looking at mostly 2017, 2018, maybe some 2019 models, depending on condition and other factors. On the other hand, a 340i, similar mileage, similar age, you'll be looking at about 28 to 35,000. So spending about an extra $8,000 to $10,000 to get the upgrade to the 340i and the larger 3-liter B58 engine. And exact price differences do depend on the exact model and the exact car. Of course, the 330i and 340i, if you look at the newest examples, the 340i is now only available as an M light model, so it's the M340i now. So obviously that has a number of chassis and other upgrades over the standard 330i. So if you look at those models, the price difference is closer to $13,000 or $14,000 if you look at MSRP on a new 330i versus a new 340i. And on the contrary, if you look at things like the 530i versus 540i, which is not the M540i, then you're looking at a much smaller price difference of about $6,000 to $7,000. Point is, depends on the exact year, model, and the difference between the chassis outside of just the engine differences, but to upgrade from the B48 into a B58 car, you will be looking at somewhere in the ballpark of probably about $6,000 to $15,000. Quite a bit more expensive to get into the B58. So that brings up the question, is the B58 really worth that extra money up front? And there isn't a perfect answer to this either. It really depends what you're looking for in a car. And so if you're really just looking for a nice, luxurious, sporty car to get from A to B, and those are your most important factors, then it probably makes sense just to stick with the B48 and save the money. However, if you're looking for the most powerful, most fun, sportiest examples, then upgrading to the B58 probably makes sense if it is in the budget. If that's not something the budget allows for and you're really dead set on having the B58, then it probably makes sense to make some compromises. Either look at models a few years older, or hold off for another 6 months or a year or more and wait for those B58 prices to come down a little bit more. Ultimately, whether or not the B58 is worth the upgrade depends on a case-by-case basis. In my opinion, I would certainly say the B58 is worth the extra money. However, at the same time, I do also own a 530i with the B48 engine in it, and part of the reason for that decision was I also have an older 2007 335i with the N54 in it, and so that's my fun weekend car. And so when I was looking to get a newer BMW, I was just looking for something to be mostly an A to B car, something to drive up to the mountains, take on road trips, pick up friends and family, and just have kind of a nice, comfortable, luxurious car to get from point A to point B. And I didn't want the B58 to get sucked into that trap of modding it and having another car that almost turns into a weekend car. And so I opted for the 530i. Now that said, if I didn't have the N54 and I were buying just one car, then I certainly would have spent the extra money and probably gone for the smaller 340i too with the B58. Just kind of one example, but just wanted to point out that the B48 is still a great engine. It's fuel efficient. It can still be fun and sporty, especially with a couple mods on it. 300 wheel horsepower on the stock turbo is nothing to be ashamed of and can still make for a fun, comfortable, just A to B car that's reliable and efficient. On the other hand, the B58 also delivers great reliability and better performance just at the cost of spending an extra roughly $10,000 upfront to purchase a B58 over the B48. That wraps up our video for the day. If you guys appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more awesome content on the B48 and B58 engines. Thanks, guys.